In today's video, we're upgrading the RC duck with a larger jet pump and a brushless motor. Let's start by disassembling the old duck to make room for all the new parts. This is the new jet pump I got from China, and it uses water to propel the boat forward. It required minimal assembly, however it didn't come with a motor, so I chose this 3100kV motor to go with it. Alright, time for a little comparison. So this is the old 16mm jet pump versus the new 26mm jet pump. And if this doesn't make the duck faster, I don't think anything will. I had to go for a new brushless ESC as the old one wouldn't have worked. However, the power connector wasn't right, so I'd done a little bit of magic here. Now it was time to solder on the new XT60 connectors, which will work with my batteries. And shortly I will be showing you a physical demonstration of the old jet pump versus the new one. But remember guys, it's only a 10mm difference in the size of the jet pump. So do let me know in the comments, did you think it was going to be that much of a difference? Alright, so that was the old one, and now for the new one. I'll let you guys be the judge of that, but anyway, let's continue with the project now. The first thing we've got to do is extend the hole, as the new jet pump now doesn't even fit. So I'll be using expandable foam to create a mold for the new fiberglass bottom. Later, I came back to the foam once it was all set and started carving it into a bolt-like shape. The first attempt didn't come out so great, it was all wonky and just wasn't what I was expecting, so I tried again, but this time I used wooden sticks to create a skeleton-like structure, so hopefully when I shaved down the foam it would hold its shape. With the original design there simply just wasn't enough space, so that's why we had to extend the hole, but sadly I still couldn't carve it into what I wanted. And that's why today's video is sponsored by JOC3DP. JOC offers a wide variety of services, which include custom PCB manufacturing, mechatronic components, 3D printing and CNC machining. So if you've got a project you're working on and simply don't have access to specialized machinery, JOC's got you covered. You simply upload your SDL file onto the website and you will receive an instant quote. Lead times are as quick as 48 hours and they offer express worldwide shipping. You then choose your material and simply place it into the basket. So order your custom parts with the link in the description. I went for the 8001 transparent resin and it turned out amazing. The finish was crystal clear and the dimensions matched perfectly. I ordered a few miscellaneous items, but this is the main part I needed, and it was a replacement for the dodgy fiberglass one I had made. And honestly, I couldn't have hoped for it to come out better than this. The next step is to modify the duck to make sure the hole fits. After cutting out the bottom, I'd done a quick test fit before we patched up the back of the duck. I made a quick template using tape to guide me with the fiberglass repair. The motor's position has now moved and the cutout above needs to be filled in. I tried to match the shape as closely as I could, but it doesn't need to be perfect because we'll use the rotary tool to fix it up. Here I'm just mixing the resin with the hardener before I apply it onto the fiberglass sheet. It only takes 20 minutes for the resin to harden, so I had to work quickly. After the final layer was done, I waited about 24 hours for the resin to cure before working on it. After removing any excess fiberglass and resin, I had done a quick test fit before drilling the 3D printed bottom. It was difficult to match the mounting holes to the duck, so again I made a template using tape. I used clear silicone sealant to create a watertight seal between the hole and the duck base. I then gently lowered the piece onto the duck and pressed down firmly to ensure both surfaces made good contact. Next were all the screws. I used M3 stainless steel nuts and bolts to ensure they didn't rust. Due to the small access hole in the top, I had to drill two small holes to reach and tighten the bolts at the front of the duck. I 3D printed a small wrench to help me tighten all the bolts inside. Here's one last look before we move on to mounting the motor and working on the steering. That last hole I bored out was for the steering rod, and here I'm trying to reuse the old rod by bending it back straight. The little brass fitting will be used to connect the steering rod to the jet pump nozzle. Next I will be making the mounts for the servo. This is used to push and pull the steering rod, which in turn changes the angle of the nozzle, turning the duck left and right. This is the 3D printed bracket I got from JLC. I designed some generic ones as I couldn't figure out the placement of the servo before the hull was complete. But now I'm going to modify them and the hull extension to make a strong mounting point. The servo can now be mounted, but first I need to fill in the holes I drilled out to make sure water doesn't get in through the front. Also, I need to make a mount for the ESC, so I use Velcro as this means it can be easily removed and not fixed in a permanent position, as I won't have any access later once everything is put together. Now I can move on to installing the motor. I use the same clear silicone to make a good seal between the motor and the hull. The silicone on the outer nozzle wasn't really necessary, but I just added it as an extra precaution. Now everything can be tightened down. And this is the metal grate that protects the jet intake from any debris entering and damaging or clogging the impeller. I wiped off any excess silicone as it will be harder to remove once it's dry. Let's finish putting the servo mount together. All the main pieces are ready inside the duct, so we can finally install the servo and mount, as it would have been in the way of when we were putting the motor in. Some more silicone was required on the mounting brackets, as water would have leaked through the holes that I drilled in the bottom of the bolt. Here I'm just lowering the bracket into the bolt so we can tighten it down. Next is the steering rod. As you can see, it's got a fitting and a rubber boot on it. This is to stop any water getting in, but also allowing the rod to move forward and back. I thought it would be wise to do a leak test before continuing, as the duct should have been watertight at this point while just floating, and I found the leak, which was quickly fixed by applying a thin layer of silicone on the outside. There were just a few more steps left to complete the steering assembly, and that is to attach the servo to the steering rod, the rod to the nozzle, and tighten the servo to the mount. Alright, so that's that, and now we can move on to the electronics. This is the receiver. It reads the signal sent out by the remote control and tells the car or bolt how to move. Today we will only be using channel 1 and 2. Channel 1 is where the steering will be plugged in. Next is the ESC. This controls the speed of the motor. The ESC also provides power to the receiver and is plugged into channel 2. Now the ESC can be connected to the motor. Although one of the wires weren't color-coded correctly, I was still able to know which wires went where by connecting the matching ones first. These batteries I made myself from some old 18650 cells. Each one has 3 in series, which means it's a 3S battery. When fully charged, they're about 12.6 volts, and I need 2 in parallel to produce enough current. Now let's test the basic functions of the duck with the remote control. By the way, on the 3S battery, the motor has a maximum RPM of around 39,000. We've only got a few more things left before we can test it. For the batteries, I'm using Velcro so I can easily take them out when I need to. The last thing left to do is somehow attach the cover to the duck, and I thought I'd just use the same method as before with the magnets and steel washers because it worked on the first version. Alright, let's test it out. As you saw, it failed miserably, but let's address all those issues. The first issue was that it seemed like it was overloaded. It was sitting too low in the water, so I weighed it and it was just over a kilo or 2.3 pounds, which is way more than it could be. The total weight of the batteries plus the connector was around 292.5 grams. So straight away I went on to Amazon and ordered the lighter battery. This one came up to just 128.4 grams. On top of the battery's weight, I could also remove all the mounting hardware. This battery actually solved two problems. One was the weight. The second was the weight distribution. I placed the battery at the front of the duck, which shifted the weight more forward. To further stop the front of the duck lifting out of the water, I added trim tabs. The last thing I wanted to tackle was the waterproofing issue. As you saw in the last test, I almost lost the duck as it filled with water from the inside, but luckily I was able to retrieve it. I used some butyl sealing tape and a Ziploc bag to make the duck waterproof. When I closed the bag, it was able to hold air, which means it will keep water out as well. I placed the lid back on top, and now it was time to weigh it again. Before any modifications, the duck was just over a kilo, and now it's only 850 grams, which is a weight reduction of around 18%. I went to test it out again, and the bird still loved it, which was good to see. However, shortly I discovered some more problems. The lid was not secured properly and it fell off. The speed increased greatly, but it wasn't stable at high speed and was practically uncontrollable. It always leaned to one side at high speeds and sometimes started hopping. One thing that did work great was the waterproofing. As you can see, the whole duck went underwater and popped out. Here's everything I changed. I 3D printed some stabilizers to improve the leaning to one side at high speed. I also 3D printed some adjustable trim tabs to deal with the hopping and added a hinge to the lid so it wouldn't fall off. The last thing I added was a scoop for the intake to stop starving it of water at high speed. So this is the speed of a real duck swimming. And this was the first version of the duck. And now I present to you the upgraded version. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe.